We will begin the Hot Dogging Snuggle Sack in just a moment. Hi everyone, it's Mikey and I'm proud to introduce a brand new pattern series by yarnspirations.com. It's called the Sleep and Snuggle Sack series. On screen now are other sleep sacks that are available in free pattern and tutorial format. Whimsical and delightful projects that will practically guarantee a warm smile from boys and girls. Super terrific for gift giving and much more. If you're wanting to try another sleep sack, then just click to play and I'll forward you directly to the next one. If you're wanting to do today's project, well, don't wait any further. Let's get started right now. Welcome back to the Crochet Crowd as well as yarnspirations.com. I'm your host Mikey. Let's begin today's tutorial on working on this fabulous Hot Dogging Snuggle Sack by yarnspirations.com. Today's tutorial is a comprehensive start to finish project. In fact, I'm working on this project behind the scenes so I can film the complete steps to be able to show you what to do. If ever you wanted to crochet a hot dog, well today is your lucky day because today we're going to be making this fun snuggle sack that'll definitely make you smile and is intended to be fun and quirky, and it's definitely a conversational crochet project. For today's project, there is a front and back to your hot dog. In fact, you'll need to crochet two wieners and four buns to make this work. Strategically sewn to make it look like one piece. Of course, the decorating of your hot dog is completely up to you, and I'll show you some tips that I did because I did my toppings a little differently. This hot dog, minus the filming and preparation time, took me about 12 hours to make. The project can be done in just a couple days, and that's of course you don't get distracted along the way. On screen is the anatomy of the hot dog and we'll return back to my workshop chalkboard in between each lesson. There are three steps involved in making this hot dog snuggle sack. Without further ado, let's examine the pattern and let's start from there. In today's pattern, we're going to do the hot dog and crochet snuggle sack, and here is a copy of the pattern. And what we need is that we need to create the buns and the wiener that is inside. Now I want to talk to you about this because this is one of those ones I had to wrap my brain around whether the child was inside the wiener itself or were they part of the buns and how was it all working on the inside. Let me go through that first and then I'll go through each of the buns and the wiener by itself. So here's a cutout of what you see the child using and the child is slipping into the front of this. Now a few things that you're gonna notice right away. The wiener is actually hanging more out of the buns at the top than it is in the bottom. The bottom it's more flat just like so. So what was happening on the back of this? This is the question I had in my brain, is that were the buns wrapping all the way around? Well no, if you look at the actual pattern you'll see that there's a second half. So what's happening here is that the front half has the mustard squirt on top. It doesn't matter which ones you really use it really. And the back half has the ketchup. So what you have to do is that you have to create four buns. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 and two wieners. 1 and 2. And what's gonna happen here is that as we get this done is that we are going to sew the bun to the wiener so it's overlapping like so. Then we're gonna sew the other bun to the wiener just like this and then we're gonna do the exact same on the other side. So sew this bun to the top of this wiener and this bun to the top of this wiener. Therefore you'll have two different panels and all you just need to do is pick them up and one will be the opposite side to what you have here. So here is the front of the snuggle sack and if you turn it over the back looks identical. So the buns are not wrapping all the way around this. In fact it's either you can wear it either way and if you want to add more toppings to your hot dog that's completely up to you. So what's happening is that once you put the two panels together you're going to sew from about this top corner all the way around and then catch it here. Change your color of the sewing right at the bottom so that the two wieners have the same string that so it matches the wiener. Change it then again and so then sew the bun up here up until this top corner. So when the child is using this they're actually using all of this in behind and not just in behind just one of the items. So this all becomes like a really kind of a big bag at the end regardless if it's front or back. So this is kind of how to look at it. So what is going on with the wiener and the buns? They're slightly different but very close to each other. So you may have noticed that there's an odd shape going on in the bun versus the wiener. The wiener really is essentially when you really truly looked at it from this perspective you can see the wiener just does this. Okay, so it's just a complete revolution like so. The bun is slightly different. The bun starts off like that for most of it like this but then the final two rounds what happens is that you're gonna grow only on the one side which is gonna make it pop out and then go back in the other direction. So what's gonna happen here is that the buns, very similar to the wiener, but has growth on one side. And when you really look at it from this perspective, do you see it? Here is the center line of the bun. Look at the difference between this here and that there. You can see it extends out more. So the side that is extending more is the outside of the bun, which gives the illusion of the shaping of a bun for a hot dog. So of all the snuggle sacks, this is the easiest one in my opinion to do. I'm gonna teach you a way today so that you can watch television and get this done at the same time without having to count all the stitches in between. I'm gonna show you some techniques on turning around on the edge here, whether it's the wiener or the bun, it's both the same concept. The wiener is slightly bigger than the buns, yeah, not only in the length but also in the thickness, just like this. And what we're going to be doing is that I'm gonna be teaching you how to address turning the corner without having to count all these stitches all the way down, because you wanna watch television. You don't wanna be sitting there counting the whole time. So I'm gonna be teaching you some techniques in order to do it, and you'll need some stitch markers for that to happen. So without further ado, let's start, and we're gonna do the wiener first in chapter number one. Okay, so now that we know what to do, let's start by crocheting our wieners first. There are two, and let's do one together, and then you can go back and do the other one on your own. So let's begin chapter number one. We're gonna do the wiener. So the wiener is individual, and you need to make two of these. So what you're seeing here is the one side of it, and then you'll make a second one then for the other side of your snuggle sack, like I've already explained. Let's go through some tips. I'm gonna bring a diagram that I made myself just to show you what to do when it comes around these corners. After we get our first chain done, we're going to be going back and around and around and around. And what I want to show you here is that if you play with stitch markers, when I go to demonstrate this in a few moments, is that if you play with stitch markers, you're going to be able to nail these really good in order without you having to significantly count as you make your way down the flat areas all the way to the other side. So when you go to start, what's gonna happen is that the starting here is actually partially way through the turn. Just like so. So when we go around, we're gonna get the first one done, go all the way, and when we come back around, we're gonna do the final four half double crochets in before joining. So then we chain up two. These chaining of two that you see here, that doesn't count as anything. They're more of just a placeholder. And when you do that, they don't really count. They're more of a builder, and you'll have a really nice finish if you consider it like that as well. So what you're going to notice is that you have to watch the start. So when we come all the way around, for example, we did two double crochets into or two half double crochets into each. The next row we do two into one, and then one into one, two into one, one into one, and you continue that same pattern until you get to the slip stitch like so. But you'll notice on the other side when we go to start, we're going to start with one half double crochet, then two, and then this one is two half double crochets, then two, and then this one is three. So this is where it kind of loses its what's that called, like balance, because normally I would have considered that the first two would have been like this in order to have these two double crochets into the same one, but it's not. It still works out, still looks great, but this is what you have to watch for at the end. So this is what's happening on the side that has the slip stitch. What is happening on the other side? It's even easier. So on the opposite side of the wiener, or even the bun, doesn't matter which one you're working with, it's still the same concept, is that you're gonna have your five half double crochets right in the edge, just like so, on the last chain before you come around. So the next one then is two into one. So what we have to do is that we have to place our stitch markers. So we're coming from here, we're going up, and then we turn. If we place stitch markers right in this section here, you don't have to count all of the stitches in order to get to this point. You just look for the stitch marker because they're building up on top of each other, just like you see. So the only difference between this row and this row is that there's more half double crochets that separate it from where it branches off, just like you see. So in this side, there's consistency. Two halves, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one. The next time you come around here is that you're going to see it here, and you're gonna see two, 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 two. And as you build out, it gets more. So on the buns and the wiener, okay, there is a slight difference because the wiener is bigger. And so in the buns, eventually the last time you will go around is that you'll have four half double crochets in a row. Okay, so you only see three here. You'll have four in a row and then two, just like this. So you'll start off here, two, and then there will be four, two, four, two. On the wiener, because it's slightly bigger by one revolution, is that there's gonna be five half double crochets and then two. So you'll start off with five, or sorry, 2 half doubles, 5. 2 half doubles, 5. And so if you can remember that, it makes it so much easier and it's a great way to count. So the trick is to make sure you use your stitch markers, whether it's the bun or the wiener, and therefore you can enjoy this process without having to count obsessively as you go through this project. So before you begin, please get 3 stitch markers. They can be leftover yarn of any color, as long as you can tell what color it is. And you'll need a total of 3 of these, and these are gonna act as your stitch markers. These are what's gonna allow you to be able to enjoy television at the same time when making this project. So let's begin to do the wiener, and we need to do an 8mm size L crochet hook, or look at the gauge of the pattern and determine that. We're using pumpkin spice as our Bernat blanket today to be the color of the wiener in this case. Of course, if you want a different color, that's completely up to you. So let's start off with the slip knot. Remember, it never counts as 1. So we're going to chain a total of 80, so just chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go all the way to 80. Meet me back here in just a moment. So I now have my 80 on the hook. So what I want to do is count 3rd chain back from the hook. So just look underneath. So 1, 2, and 3. Turn it over and get the back loop only, and I want you to half double crochet into the back loop of the chain. Once you do the first back loop, the rest of the chain will stay turned upside down, and moving down the back loops of the entire chain, I want you to half double crochet up until you get to the other side, where I'm gonna show you how to do the first turn around, because what's gonna happen is that we're gonna go along this chain, turn around on the same chain, and then come up through the bottom on the bottom side to create a whole revolution. So continue just to half double crochet yourself down the chain. I'll see you at the end of this chain. Okay, so now I'm all the way down the chain except for the very last one. So the very last one, we wanna put in 5 half double crochets in there. So let's start the count. So 1, 2, and you're gonna see the project's gonna naturally rotate because there's too many stitches going into it. So this is 3, 4, and 5. So that's all right in the very end. So now that your 5 are in, I want you to go back to the very first one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go back to the first one, and right where that first one is of the group of 5, I want you to stick in your hook and put a stitch marker in there. This will indicate next time you come here, this is where it's going to start for putting in 2 double crochets into the same stitch for when we come back on this row. So what we're gonna do is that we're gonna continue to rotate the project, okay, and starting right in the next stitch that's available to you, okay? So don't get confused by all of this extra yarn. It's right here. Okay, do you see that? So all this is 1, so it's the first one here. And what I want you to do is grab that straggler that you started with and just put that as part of it just to trap it into position and underneath the stitches. So I want you to half double crochet yourself all the way back to the other side, and I want you to stop the one that's prior to hitting the very end. So just half double crochet yourself across. Once you get this this straggler in long enough, then you can just let it go and just trim out the rest. So I would probably let it go at this point. It's in enough, and just continue to half double crochet yourself all the way, and I'll see you at the last stitch before you turn the corner. So as you come all the way back across, you're going to run into what appears to be 2 stitches left, and there's only appears to be only 1 stitch, and this is the stitch that you want to concentrate. And I will show you the diagram in just a few moments, but you got to put it in trust in me right now. So here's the last one. So don't worry about this one that's out here. Here's the last one. I want you to put in 4 half double crochets into that same one. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that other one that was kind of standing out in the middle of nowhere, the other side, you remember we did 5 half double crochets? Well, here is the 5th. It's right here. And so once you get these 4 in, just join it to the top of the other one there. And before you continue, what I want you to do is that I want you to go back to the very starting one. Okay, there was 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Slip in your hook into that 4th one. Okay, it was the very starting one. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and slip in a stitch marker there. So when you come back around, always on this round, you can count on this stitch marker being your indication of where you're gonna start putting your 2 in there, and then you're gonna carry on as you go all the way around. You don't need to do one right here, the stitch marker, because it becomes very obvious. Let me bring up the diagram and let me show you where we are and what we're gonna be doing next. So here's the diagram of where we are right now. We just came and did the 4. We just did the join. So we're going to move up and we're gonna chain 2, and then we're gonna put 2 half double crochets in the first one, and then half double crochets all the way down the other side. You're going to then get to the other side, and once where you get to the stitch marker that I had you label, you're gonna put two into that one and then one into each one of these all the way around. Okay, so here's your five. There's gonna be two double crochets. Once you again then get back and you're gonna half double crochet yourself all the way, right where you've placed the stitch marker is you're gonna start doing your twos right there and then come here. So you can kind of see the rhythm that's going on regardless of what side of the hot dog that you're working on, just like this. So let's move along to round number. So let's begin round number two. We're gonna chain up two, and as I explained in the very first intro of this video is that the first two never counts as anything. It's more of a builder. So you're going to look and you see 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And this is a builder here. So here is your fifth. Do you see how it's all linked into the same? That's the one right here. And that's where you're gonna put two half double crochets. Everything is a half double crochet in this one, except for the very final revolution of the buns. So what we're going to do then is that we're gonna put two into that one, and then we're just gonna carry on all the way down now to the other side until you get to the other stitch marker on the other side of the wiener in order to make it work. So just half double crochet to the next stitch marker, and I'll see you there in just a moment. So I'm coming up to the other side of the wiener, and this is round number two, so this is where we're turning around before heading back toward this slip stitch to complete. So here's where the stitch marker is where I had you label. So right where the stitch marker is, you have to place in two double crochets, or sorry, two half double crochets into that same one. So one and two. So that instead of me counting all the way back across, I'm looking for these stitch markers. Now you wanna move that stitch marker up right now, don't wait. And I want you to stick in the stitch marker right here. Okay, so just right behind it. And that's an indication of next time you get here, that's where you're going to start and put two half double crochets once again. So what we have to do in the remaining of the four that are left is that each one of these are gonna have two half double crochets each. So as I'm talking to you and going around, so what's gonna happen in the rows above this is going to be that we're gonna place in half double crochets that stand by themselves to separate where these are going into in order to compensate for the bend. So you need a total of five of these. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and here's your fifth right here. Okay, so what I would do if it were me, that third stitch marker that I had you put aside, I want you to place it right here. Okay, and what's that's gonna indicate as you get bigger, sometimes it's harder to count those five as you go around. So it gives you a nice visual clue on where you are when you're going all the way around, and it will make sense as we get around. So place your stitch marker in there. So now that you've gone all the way around this particular bend, you're gonna continue down the other side now, and it is all just gonna be half double crochets until you get to the final stitch marker on the other side where we're gonna do the final bend before then attaching, as we've done a whole revolution. So half double crochet down until you get to the next stitch marker. So I'm coming to the other side. Here's the stitch marker. So if you can see here, you see this is where we started. It looks a little misshaped. That's where we started. So, and it's misshaped because because we haven't finished all the way going around. So I'm just half double crocheting until I get to the stitch marker, and it's the next one. So in that stitch marker, just like we did on the other side, we wanna push in two half double crochets in there. And again, just like we did before, so that right here, okay, move up that stitch marker right now. Therefore, you'll have it in place next time you get around here. And now you will continue then putting in two half double crochets then for the remaining of this turn. There's a four of them in a row. So this is the third one. And I'm going until I run out of stitches essentially. So I don't really need to count it. I can see it. So there you go. So I have my four in here, and all I'm just gonna do then is that I'm going to join it to the top of where this chain two was. Okay, so it's the first half double crochet, just like that. And that completes off that revolution. So it was misshaped, and now I've come all the way around, and now it looks perfect once again. Let's begin round number three. So let's begin round number three. So here we are, we just finished these, all these two were in a row. Now we're gonna chain up two, half double into the first one, and then the next one is gonna have two half double crochets into the same one, and then we're gonna half double crochet ourselves all the way down until we get to the next stitch marker. the next stitch marker will put in two, and then there will be one by itself, put in two, one by itself, and you continue to do that. And right where I have placed that last stitch marker here as we came up all the way around, remember I said it's just a help as a visual, just gives you indication of where you're gonna finish, and then you're just gonna half double crochet yourself back across, and you get to the other side right where the stitch marker is. You'll put in two, then one, two, one, two, one, two, one, and join. Let's begin round number three. So let's begin round number three. We're gonna chain up two, doesn't count as anything, and we look at it. So these are the two that are into the same one. We saw that before. So the very starting one, okay, the first one of the two is gonna get one half double crochet by itself, and then the next one is gonna get two half double crochets in the same one. And then that concludes the turn of this particular side. And now we're just gonna half double crochet ourselves all the way down until we get to the next stitch marker on the other side, and we'll obviously we'll complete this side of the turn when we get back around. I'll see you on the other side with this stitch marker. So I'm coming up to the stitch marker that's on the other side. So because this is round number three, right where the stitch marker is where we're gonna put in two half double crochets, and this is round three, so then the next half double crochet is by itself. Okay, so then the next one has two, and then the next one, oops, sorry, that's a half double crochet. The next one is by itself for a half double crochet. And you notice I'm really not counting how many I should do. There should be a total of five of those sets, by the way, but I'm not really counting. I'm letting my stitch markers show me the way. Okay, so this is happens to be the third one. You know, I kind of count in my brain anyway, but here is the fourth that's going in. There's two into this one. And the next one is one by itself. And see this last stitch marker? That's the very last time you'll put in two. Do you get that? Isn't that neat? So if you can do that and keep with the pattern, it makes a lot of sense. So right before I go on, I want to move up my stitch marker. So I want you to move up that stitch marker to right where you are. You'll see that next time you come around. And this other one here, do you remember that it was two? Just stick in your hook. See, it's kind of in between them two. Stick in your hook there and grab that other stitch marker and pull it through there, and then you'll see that next time too. You're gonna notice that these stitch markers kind of go off on an angle like so in order to stay balanced. So all you gotta do now at this point is just half double crochet yourself back to the other side, and I'll see you at the first stitch marker there where we'll finish off the rotation for round number three. So I'm coming up all the way back around to where we started. See how it's kind of odd shaped here? That's because that's where we started and we came all the way back around. Right where that stitch marker is where we're gonna start the fun for this time around. So there's the stitch marker. We're gonna place in two half double crochets there. I'm gonna move up the stitch marker now before I forget. So I'm just right where the last one is, just pulled through the stitch marker so you know where it is next time. Are you loving that you don't really have to count too much? So the next one is gonna be one half double crochet by itself. The next one is two. And then the next one is one. The next one is two. Okay, next one is one. And next one is two. And I wanna verify that. I'm just gonna verify because I got one more stitch left. And so I got one, two, three, four. Here's the fourth, and we have to finish it with one by itself. See, I've gone all the way around, and let's just join it to the top of the beginning half double crochet. So just right over here, just slip stitch it in, and there you go. So I've now just gone all the way around once again. So let's move on to round number four. On to round number four. This is where we've just finished off. See how we did all this double in a row and then one by itself and then joined. So the next one we're gonna chain up two. There will be two in a row by itself and then the two, and then we're gonna go down the line, come down to the other side, and then we're going to get in two right into where we have the first one marked with a stitch marker, then two in a row, then two, and then two in a row, and two. So what I'm gonna do is that this particular chart doesn't take you all the way around of all the different stitches, but you can see the growth rate is all very consistent with each other. And so as I'm coming all the way around now, I'm going to be explaining it more than showing this diagram. When we get all the way back around, then the other side, there will be two right where the stitch marker is, and then two by itself, two, and then two, 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 and then finish off with two singles, and then slip stitch it, and then move it even further. So let's continue along with round number four. So let's begin round number four. We're gonna chain up two, okay, and we look down, see how there's two in the same one here. There's one by itself, so that one by itself is gonna continue to be by itself. So let's add a half double crochet there, okay, and we gotta add in another half double crochet into the next stitch. And the easiest way I can see how these two are in here. So this half is in the first one, so the last one that is the second one in is going to have two half double crochets. So there was two by itself and then two into the one, and now you're just gonna half double crochet yourself down the side of this, and I'll meet you on the other side for the stitch marker for round number four. So I'm coming on to the other side of the wiener, and right where the stitch marker is where we're gonna start playing and doing the fun turn once again. So the next one is the stitch marker, so this one will have two into this one, and in this particular one, round number four, there's going to be half double crochets by itself. What I want you to do, move up that stitch marker before you continue, then you know where it is next time. Okay, so as I said, there's two half double crochets in a row by itself for this revolution, and then there's two into the next, and then there's two into, one into the next two, and then two into the next, then two in, one into the next two. So I'm getting that little messed up in my brain. I know what to do, it's just saying it. Okay, two into the next, and the next two are by themselves, and look where that last stitch marker is. Mm-hmm, you got that right. So that last one is right where the last two into the same one is, or are. Okay, so that's it, and let's continue all the way down the other side now with just a half double crochet in each until you get to the next stitch marker where we'll finish off round number four. So as you're coming up all the way to the other side, we're just rounding the corner where we had started. So right where the stitch marker is, you're going to place in two half double crochets, move up that stitch marker right away so you don't forget to do that, and right, it's right in the last one here, and that'll help you greatly. This is round number four. So round number four, then the remaining of this turn is two will be by itself just like we were on the other side, and then the next one is two into the same one. Okay, and then the next one is two by itself, one and two. The next one is two into the same one, two by itself. The next one is two into the same one, and then the final two stitches, see, you're running out of stitches, you only got two left, just one into each, and that's it. So that is round number four. Just join it to the top of where you started. Just like that. So that was round number four. So you can see, does a really great job. Let's move along to round number five. So round number five is the starting, kind of the similar to how we've already been doing. The only difference is that there's more half double crochets in between where two exist. Let's chain up two. Remember, does not count as anything, and we come into the first half double crochet, and we do that one, and then we do two more half double crochets in a row, not into the same one, so in a row, so one and two. So this time in this round, there's three half double crochets that sit by itself. See the next one? It's the second half of where two are into the same one. That means that we're on the right track, and there's gonna be two into that one as well. So let's move down the side of this wiener, and let's go to the other side, and I'll see you at the first stitch marker. So I'm coming up to the other side of the wiener right where the stitch marker is. Again, you are putting in two. You get that? So in the buns, it's exactly the same thing that we're doing here. The only difference is the last two rounds of the buns are slightly different. So what we want to do is the next three are gonna be by itself. So 1, 2, and 3. It's like a race track really when you're running around a track. The more outside that you get of the radius, the more stitches are needed. So the next one's gonna have two into the same one, and then three by itself once again. And I continue that same pattern until I get to that other stitch marker on the other side of this rotation to show me exactly where I need to stop doing that. I'm not one for counting stitches if I don't really have to, and this is one of those tricks. So there's two into that one because I did three by itself, and now another three by itself. Just like that. Two into the next one, and then the next three are by itself. 1, 2, and 3. Now it looks like I forgot to move out that stitch marker last time, but I can see that it is right where it should be anyway. So I'm gonna put two into that one, and I'm not gonna forget this time. So again, don't forget your stitch markers. It makes a difference. Might have fallen out too. I doubt it though. I think it's probably more me than anybody. So I can't blame anybody but myself. Okay, so then I'm just going to half double crochet them myself all the way down to the other side, and then we'll finish off this revolution, which is round number 5, and there is only two more rounds after this. So you can see it doesn't take long really to do these wieners, and make sure that you do two of them. I'll see you on the other side. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of round number 5, and I'm getting my stitch marker, which is next. So here it is, and that's gonna get two this time. Well, it did every time. Every time we hit the stitch marker, it's the starting point. And I'm just gonna move up my stitch marker now before I forget. So remember on round number 5 then, there's three that sit alone by itself. So 1, 2, and 3. And then two into the next one. 1 and 2. Okay, and then three again. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay, two into the next one. Okay, and then three by itself. Okay, and then two into the next one. And this is the final time you'll do it because there's only three stitches left. 1, 2, and 3. And you know what? I really didn't count it. It just, this pattern is so easy that you can count on yourself being accurate as long as you use stitch markers. So then now that that's done, just join it to the beginning one right over here. Remember that chain two does not count as anything. So just right at the very top and bring that to a slip stitch, and that concludes off round number 5. There you go. So just got a couple more rounds to go, and then your wiener's done. So let's move on to round number 6. Round number 6, there's going to be 4 half double crochets in a row before we hit and then put 2 right in the very beginning. So let's chain up 2. Remember, it doesn't count as anything. Moving to the first one, so there's going to be 4 halves in a row, 4 half double crochets. Sometimes I use abbreviations when I'm doing these tutorials, and sometimes people don't get that I'm actually using them. Okay, so we got this 2, 3, and 4. Just like that. So therefore you're here. See how the two are in the same one? So the next one, which is the second one of the two, will have 2 half double crochets in there. So now you're just gonna move down your wiener to the other side, and I'll see you over there at the stitch marker, and I'll show you how to go around for number 6. So we're now coming up to the other side of the wiener for round number 6, and when I hit that stitch marker, I'm going to do my rotation around. So by this point in the tutorial, you should have understood by now that you're repeating this to go around the whole circle, and what I'm about to show you is going to be the same. So I'm just gonna show it to you once because I think that you're grasping. So right when you're on the stitch marker, you're gonna apply 2, and for this one going around then, there's gonna be 4 half double crochets in a row before you put in two once again. So this is 2, 3, and 4, and then in the next one you're going to put 2 again. Okay, so continue that all the way around. You have your other marking of where the last 2 will go into, and then you'll continue again half double crochet all the way to the other side where I'll meet you over here. So do this round coming around, go all the way, and I'll see you at the end of this round where I'll show you how to finish it off. And also make sure, just one second, make sure that you do move up that stitch marker because you have one more round to go after this. Don't forget that. So I'm coming to the other side. This is where we started on the other side and went around, and now I'm back at the stitch marker where I'm gonna finish up this rotation. Now my wiener has gotten a lot bigger. I just gotta get one more revolution in and then it's nice and fat and juicy, ready for using. So what we have here is this is the stitch marker. So we're gonna place 2 into this one, and on this revolution number 6 there was 4 half double crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Once you get your 4 done, the next one is another 2. So 1 and 2 into the same one, and then another 4 by itself. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like that. And now let's just turn my wiener a little bit. So the next one, 1, 2, 3, so the next one has 2 into there, this one. So 1 and 2, and then 4 by itself. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we're almost done my wiener. So the next one we have 2 into the same one, and then the last 4 are 1 half double crochet by itself. So 1, 2, 3, and the last one to conclude round number 6, just like this, and just join it to the top of the first stitch. So we got one more revolution, round number 7, to conclude the wiener, and therefore you can see it's going really quite perfectly on both sides, just like you see here. So let's do number 7 and get this wiener done. Remember that you need to do 2 wieners in order to make this snuggle sack. So let's begin round number 7. Chain 2, remember, doesn't count as anything. So the next 5 are gonna be by itself, and then the next one after that is gonna be 2 into here. So you see here's where the 2 is, right where my thumb is. The second one right where the thumb is where the 2 is gonna be into. So let's put 5 half double crochets in a row. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and I'm on now the second one, see that? And that is the one that's gonna have 2. So I want you to half double crochet yourself down the side of the wiener, and I'll see you back on the other side where we'll do the rotation around and then meet back up here and we'll get this done to conclude today's wiener. So I'm coming on the other side of the wiener, as I'm gonna go all the way around this section right here, do you see? And so I'm at the stitch marker in just a couple stitches, and that one's gonna get 2, of course, if you've been following my drift all along. So here's where we are. You do not need to move up the stitch marker. This is the last rotation. This is how big your wiener is gonna get. So in this one here, you got 2 into the same, and then there's gonna be 5 half double crochets by itself, and then 2 again. So I want you to do that all the way around as you turn this corner, and then remember that the last stitch marker that I'm having you move up is where the last 2 are in, and then you're gonna half double crochet yourself back to the beginning where I'll meet you back there, and I'll show you how to finish off this revolution, and then this wiener is done. Remember that you still have to do 2 of these all together in order to come up with a complete set. So I'll leave that with you. I'll see you back at the end of this rotation. So I'm coming to the conclusion. This is where we started on this rotation. This is round number 7. This is the final as we go. So here's the stitch marker to indicate this is where I'm gonna start. We're gonna place in 2, and then this time, just like we did on the other side, is gonna be 5 half double crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And please repeat that same idea. So 2 into the next, then 5 to the next, and do it right to the very end, and I'll see you there in just a moment. So I'm coming to the conclusion. I'm just joining it to the top, And that's it. So the wiener is now done. So what I want to do is that I want to trim about 12 inches long a strand of string. I'm gonna pull it through the loop, and because the child will be using this and because this is an outside edge of a project, the chances of weaving this in and out is very strong for it to fall out, just as the way it is. So what you want to do is you want to take this strand and you want to run it through with the darning needle underneath some of the stitch work and just bury it underneath, and you want to go back and forth underneath the stitches about 3 times. Just take your time at doing this. So this is one, going back in the other direction through a different path but in the other direction. So this is two, and going finally back in the other direction for number 3. So when you go back and forth 3 times like this, it will never fall out because your project cannot stretch in 3 different directions at one time. So that's how you would go to finish this off with both wieners plus the hot dog when you're ready to do so. So that's it. You can now pull out your stitch markers. You just have to do now the second wiener in order to continue. So I'd recommend, you know, you might as well do both wieners at the same time. Get them both done and then you're ready on for the buns, which will be the next part of today's tutorial. So now I have this. Now I've already done one wiener off camera. So now I've already got 2 done and I'm gonna be ready for the assembly once I get the buns complete. And I'll see you in the next chapter. Good job on your wieners. Now it's time to move on and make those buns. There are 4 buns and the wiener is positioned in between the buns. They are sewn directly onto the wieners and partially over top to give the illusion that they look like the wiener is tucked in between the buns. So let's crochet. So we're now back and we're going to do the buns next. Remember what I talked about in the intro, that there's actually 4 buns here. So there's one on this side, one on the opposite, one on this side, and one on the opposite side of that. So in actual fact, what you have here is that you have 2 sets of panels like this. And then eventually as we get closer, you'll notice that the wiener is hanging out one side more than the other. Okay, do you see that? And they will just be attached so that they're opposite. So you have 2 sides that look identical to each other. So let's talk about the buns a little more detail because there's something slightly different versus the wiener. So here's the front and back. Depends on you what you consider front and back. You know, I like ketchup. I don't really like mustard, so that would be my front for sure. And of course you can decorate your hot dogs any way that you wish at the end. Now you're going to notice here that we've just finished the wiener. The wiener was strictly just straight down and back around the corner like so. Now the bun is pretty much almost the same and it goes for up to round number 6, and then what's gonna happen then in round number 7 and 8 is that we're gonna stop and we're gonna go and we're just gonna do a portion like this, and then the other one is just gonna be portion growing back out again and stopping. So what you're looking at here, do you notice that the center line here is right here? This side is more bigger than this side. That's the side that you're growing on to give the shape of the bun. So this side here, if you just kind of use your eyes and just follow it around, you'll see that there's a shaping going on within the buns, and you can see it on the opposite side as well. So when you're going to sew this then together with the rest of it, you gotta make sure that the side that has the growth is on the outside of the hot dog in order to keep it uniform just like this. So at the very end, what we're going to do then is that once the buns are complete, we're going to sew the bun like this, so it overlaps the wiener just like you see here, and you're gonna do both sides. Then you have one complete panel. You're gonna do the same with the other side, have one complete panel. But what I would do if I were you, do one first, it becomes your prototype for the next, and then just lay your panels over top of the other one, making sure it's all lining up, and then just sew what you see here. So in this part of the tutorial, what I'm gonna do for you is that the wiener and the buns are very similar to each other. So up until round 6 is identical to each other. So it's the last 2 sections of last 2 rows that's gonna change the story. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna just quickly talk about it, but I'm not gonna be as detailed of stopping and starting in between each one of the revolutions like I did with the wiener, because I really think that you got it by now, and we're gonna cover that next. So bringing back my charts just like so, what we have is we have the starting side, and we're gonna start exactly where we did before in the wiener, and we're gonna start up here, and then we're gonna do 1 increase before we then go all the way down to the other side till we hit the round the point and come back around and then back up. So what's gonna happen here is the buns have 2 in the maximum circle or the rotation. There's gonna be 2 into the same and then 4 okay? And the wiener had two into the same and then five. So you can see that the buns are slightly smaller other than the two sections that we have to do right at the very end. So what I'm gonna do for you is that we're gonna get you started with the stitch markers. Again, exactly what we did with stitch markers within the wiener. It's the exact same thing, and I don't think I need to stop and start as often with you. I'll tell you how to get started, because really if I tell you, for example, in this round here that there's one that stands by itself and then there's two double crochets in the next, look here, see, two in the next, one by itself, two in the next, one by itself. So how I get started is how you're gonna do the other side and then come back around. You'll find the other stitch marker and do the other same. So two into one, one into one, two, one, two, one, and etc. So hopefully that makes a lot of sense for you, and let's get started, and let's grab your sand color, which is the color of the buns. So let's get started. You're going to need three stitch markers like we did with the wiener, and you'll need those. So put those aside so that they're nice and handy for you. The buns are not as long, or nor are they as thick. This will go a lot faster than the wiener. So let's begin with the slip knot, and for the buns it's chaining of 70. So remember that slip knot never counts as one. So we'll just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go all the way to 70 for me. I'll see you back here in just a moment. Okay, just like the wiener, we have our 70 done for the bun size, and we're gonna count back to the third one. So 1, 2, 3, turn it over, get the back loop only, and then half double crochet in that one. So what I want you to do is that I want you to half double crochet yourself all the way to the other side of this chain, and on the very last one I'll meet you there, and we'll do something different in order to go around in a circle like we did with the wiener. So half double crochet yourself all the way to the last stitch and just hold last one in the chain and just hold there and wait for me. So I'm coming up close to the end. I just got one more to do after this one, and that is the final one, which is next right there. So here's the final. So the very final one that we want to do is that we want to put in 5 half double crochets into that same one, and we're gonna rotate the project naturally as it goes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just like that. So without further ado, I want you to go back to the very first one, okay, and that's where I want you to stick your crochet hook, and that'll be the very first stitch marker that you put in. That'll give you the indication of when you need to do that, when you're activating it all the way around. So do you see where it is? That's where you need to put it next time. So you just keep moving up from there. So now all we're just gonna do is turn this over and go along the chain on the underside. Make sure that you put this string down on top so that it gets tucked into position, and all you're just gonna do now is half double crochet. You're working on the opposite side of the chain naturally, and you're gonna go to the very last chain here on the other side, and then I'll show you what to do there, because you gotta rotate around that one too if you remember from the wiener. So I'll see you there in just a moment. So I'm coming up all the way to the other side, and I'm going into my very last one. So it's like on the wiener, okay, you have one last stitch. You got this one that's appearing out. This is the fifth one of the turn as we're going around. So you're gonna go into the last one just like this, and you're gonna do it for 1, and you're gonna do it for 2, you're gonna do it for 3, and 4. So with that other one that's holding out like this, that is your fifth. So what I want you to do is that I want you to slip stitch it to the top of that very first one, and that concludes that one, that round. Before you continue though, the 4 that you had, I want you to go in just after the first one, and I want you to place your stitch marker there to give you the indication next time that you come there that that's where you're gonna start the rotation when you come back all the way across your bun, just like this. Okay, let's move up to round number 2. Let's begin round number 2. We're gonna chain up 2, doesn't count as anything, and in the very first one right here, okay, there's gonna be 2 half doubles into the same one. So for this one, when we hit the corners, there's just gonna be 2 into each as you're building outward. So then once you get your 2 into that one, it's just 1 half double crochet until you hit the other stitch marker on the other side of the turn, and I'll see you there in just a moment. I'm coming up to the very end of the other side as we turn the corner. So on round number 2, just like we did with the wiener, so on this side we're going to then put in 2 half double crochets in each, and the stitch marker is indicating the very first one. So here's 1 and 2, and you keep doing that so that you got 5 in a row like that. So that's 1 out of 2. So do it again. So 1 and 2, that's number 2. The next one is number 3. And the next one is number 4. So 2 into that one as well. So as we turn the corner. And then the very final one here, there's 2 into this one. So what I want you to do at this point is that I want you to put your last stitch marker in right here. So that's your very third one, and that'll indicate where you're coming all the way around. So now I want you to continue and make your way back to the very beginning of this revolution and simply just put in 1/2 double crochet into each, and I'll see you on the other stitch marker as we bring this round to conclusion. Before I move on, I wanna make sure that you move up your stitch marker and the very first one. Remember, here's where the 2 is. It's right in between the 2. That is where you need to move it up. Don't forget to move that up or you'll mess up as you go. So please make sure you do that and then continue along. I knew I forgot something, I just didn't know what. So let me continue. So I'm now on the other side. Here's the stitch marker, and on this side here, this is where we're gonna start. We're gonna put 2 into this one and 2 into each one of them as we hit back toward the starting point right over here. There should be a total of 4 of those in a row. So this is the second one of 4. This is the third one of 4. So there's 2 in this one as well. And then the final one is the next one, and this one has 2. So you're just going to join it then to the beginning, the top of the beginning, and that concludes off round number 2. Make sure you go right into a chain and not a gap space, because you will have it, it'll look open if you don't do that. So that's how you do that. So that is round number 2. Again, come back to the very starting over here and move up your stitch marker so that you know where to find it next time. Okay, so let's continue with round number 3. So round number 3, we're going to chain 2, and then the first one is going to be 1 double crochet by itself. Oops, that went right into a gap. Go right into the top of a stitch. So go right in top of a stitch, just like this. And then the next one, if you look at it, see how there's 2 into the same one? The second one here, that is going to have 2 into that one this time. So there's 1 by itself and then 2 into the next. So we're gonna come all the way down now, 1/2 double crochet until you get to the next stitch marker. And then in the next stitch marker, you're gonna put in 2 and then 1, 2 and then 1, 2 and then 1. I'll see you there in just a moment. As you make your way across your bun, on the other side, you'll have the stitch marker, and in that one, you'll place in your 2/2 double crochets as normal. Okay. And make sure you move up that stitch marker so that you don't forget to do that, so you can identify it next time. So then for this one, as you're turning around the end here, the next one will be 1 by itself. Okay, the next one will have 2. And you keep doing that until you get to that other stitch marker that you developed. Okay, so then the next one's 1 by itself. There's a total of 5 of these groups, by the way, just so if you're counting out loud. So the next one is 2. Next one is 1. Next one is 2. And 1. So here is the other stitch marker. So that one is the last one of the group of 5. So I just wanna verify. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I was counting the groups of 2. This is the final group of 2 for number 5. Just like this. So 1 and 2, and I wanna move up my stitch marker so I can identify that again next time. Okay, so when you're coming all the way around on future ones, all the difference is that there's gonna be more single crochet, or sorry, more half double crochet standing by itself versus the ones that are 2 into the same. Half double crochet yourself now back to the other stitch marker, which then is the conclusion of this round, which is number 3. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of round number 3. And so here's the stitch marker. So there's gonna be a 2 into this one. So as we make our way back to the very start, right here, there's going to be a consistent pattern. So the next one is gonna be 1 by itself, and then the next one will be 2. Please do that same idea going all the way back to the start, just like this. And there will be 4 groups of those. So there's 1 and 2 so far. Actually, I might as well just finish that off with you. So there, here's the 1 by itself. The next one has got 2. My goal is that I can just tell you what to do next time and show you exactly what to do as we go. So the 1 by itself. So here is the conclusion. this is two into the same one, and then finally the last stitch is one by itself. So once you get that done, just join it to the top of the beginning, and that will conclude off round number 3. So we're at the halfway point and ready to move on to round number 4. So 1, 2 builder. So okay, so this time what we're going to have here is that we're gonna have 2 half double crochets in a row. So make sure you go right into a stitch and not a gapping space. So we got 1 and 2, and just like it was with the wiener, see the next one, see it's got the group of 2 right underneath. This is the next one, which is the second one, and there's gonna be 2 into that one. So what I want you to do is half double crochet yourself down the side of the bun, and I'll see you at the first stitch marker. So in round number 4, I'm coming up to the other side where we're gonna zip around the corner, and here is my stitch marker. So in this round number 4 is that there's gonna be 2 into where that stitch marker is, and I'm gonna move up that stitch marker before I forget. Just like so. And then what I want to do then is that the next one will be by itself. Okay, and then the next one is going to be by itself. Okay, so that's the repeat pattern for this time around. So last time it was just 1 by itself, this time it's 2. So I want you to do that same patterning going all the way around until you get to that stitch marker on this side here. Once you get to this stitch marker, that's the last time you'll put 2 in there, and then you'll zip along the other side with half double crochets back to the very beginning. Please do that same patterning going all the way around. I'll see you at the end of this revolution. So I'm coming back around to where it started on round number 4. And right where the stitch marker is right here is going to be 2. I'm gonna move up that stitch marker before I forget, so I can capture it on round number 5. Okay, and so then this one here is a repeat pattern, so the next 2 are by themselves. So 1 and 2, and then the next one is 2 into the same one, and continue that same pattern going all the way right to the start. It just is a couple more times after this. So 2 into the next, or 1 into the next 2, 2, 1 into the next 2, and so on, and then join to the very top, just like this. So I'm just finishing up. It's the last 2 are by themselves, and then just join it to the top of the beginning. That was round number 4. So let's begin round number 5. I can start right away because I completely understand this pattern. So we're gonna chain up 2. Remember, it doesn't count as anything. So last time we had 2 standing by themselves, this time it's gonna be 3. So that means that the next 3 are by themselves. So let's begin. So the first 3 are 1 half double crochet each. I'm trying to avoid going into a space. I wanna get right into that first element here. It makes the world a difference in the visuals. So that was 1, 1, and then 2 and 3. So 3 by themselves. Here you have 2, just like there. So this is the second one of the 2, which is the next one. There'll be 2 into that one. So I want you to half double crochet yourself now down the side of the bun to the next stitch marker, and I'll see you there in just a moment. So I'm coming around to the other side of the bun as we're gonna whip all the way around, and this time when we get to the stitch marker, there's going to be 2 into that first one, and then there's going to be 3 that stand alone. Okay, so that's the 2 into the first one. Let's move up that stitch marker. We only have one more revolution to do after this, so that makes it quite nice and easy. So this one is smaller than the wiener, so it goes quicker. And what I want you to do is that I want you to put in 3 half doubles by itself and continue that same pattern going all the way around until you get to the other stitch marker. The other stitch marker indicates the last time you will do the half double crochet 2 into the same one, and then you'll whip across and do the half doubles all the way back to the beginning. So remember, it's 2 into the 1 and then 3, 2 into 1 and then 3. Do that all the way around for this turn, and I'll see you back at the beginning of this revolution. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of round number 5, and I've started over here, so I'm coming around. So right where the next stitch marker is where I'm gonna start putting my 2 in. So there'll be 2 into this one. I'll move up my stitch marker in just a moment. So this time we're gonna do 3 by itself. So 1, 2, and 3, and then the next one has 2 again, and continue to repeat that same pattern going all the way until you hit this here, and it should be on the end of the 3 as well as when you go to join it. Okay, so see you back there in just a moment, and I'm gonna move up my stitch marker before I forget, and we have one more revolution to do, which is round number 6 after this. So I'm concluding round number 5, and the last 3 are just 1 half double crochet each. And then we're just going to join it to the top of the first one, and we're gonna move up to round number 6. So round number 6, really quite straightforward. So the last time there was 3 by itself, this time there will be 4. So 1, 2 doesn't count as anything. So I'm looking towards where the 2 are in here, right where my thumb is. Okay, so the first 4 are all going to be 1 half double crochet by itself. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like this. And then the next one is the second one of the 2, and there'll be 2 into that one. So now just half double crochet, just 1 into each until you get to the next stitch marker on the other side of your bun. So I'm coming up to the other side of the bun where we have to whip around the corner. So then the first one with the stitch marker will have 2 half double crochets in it, just like this. And now this time there's going to be 4 half double crochets in a row by itself. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then 2 into the next one. So continue that same idea. Remember that the last stitch marker here is the last time you'll put 2 in there, and then you'll whip along with half double crochet right back to the start of this rotation. So once you get this rotation done, I'll see you on the other side. We'll touch base and I'll show you what to do next. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of round number 6, and I'm hitting the stitch marker, and that means that I've got to turn around and go back to where I've started right here. So this one here where the stitch marker is, don't forget to this is the last time you have to use this stitch marker, so you don't need to move it up at this point. And what I need you to do is that you got 2 into that one, and then the next 4 are by themselves. And I want you to continue that same idea going all the way back to the start. So there's, this is the 3rd one and the 4th, and the next one will be 2 once again, and continue that. So once you get your 2 and do another 4 by itself, and so on, and then just slip stitch it to the top of the beginning one over here. And then we're gonna start then and create and go in a different direction for 2 more steps in order to complete today's bun. Okay, so the final 4 are by itself. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and that concludes the revolutions for doing the hot dog. Okay, so just join it, but you're not done yet. You got 2 more things you need to do, so do not fasten off at this point. So this is what it will look like here, and now I'm gonna take you to the paper and I'm gonna show you what's gonna go on next. So you've completed rounds 1 through 6 at this point, and now it's time for the next 2 steps that we need to do. You will notice here that this seems to take a really weird turn, and right here, right in the end on this side and on this side, there's more to it. Let me show you another one. I've actually got all the buns complete off camera, the ones that we're going to do here. So what you can see here is that, do you see what's going on right here? Yep. So what's gonna happen, we're gonna pick up and we're gonna go all the way across. When we get to the other side, we're gonna stop, turn our work, and come all the way back here. Okay, so what's gonna happen when you really look at it from this point of view, this section right here is done and is not done on the other side, so therefore it gives you the shape of the bun. Hopefully that makes a lot of sense to you, and I'm gonna show you some easy ways to count that in order to get this shape. And then basically once you put things together and you sew the bun to the wiener, when on both sides, when you go to do that, you gotta make sure that the growth side is on the outside of the bun in order to keep its shape so it's accurate. So what's gonna happen in here, we're gonna chain 1 and we're gonna put 1 single crochet into the very first one and then 9 as per the pattern. But I want you to look at it this way. We're gonna do 10 single crochets in a row, then 10 half double crochets in a row, 43 double crochets in a row, 10 half double crochets in a row, and then 10. Once you get to the other side, you're going to slip stitch over to the next one and then begin to do 10 single crochets again, 10 half double crochets, 43 double crochets back, and then 10 half double crochets back, and 1 single crochet, or 10 single crochets back when you get there. So you're gonna go down like this and then back like that. So you gotta make sure you turn, I guess, at the bottom so that you remember to do that. So if you remember 10, 10, 43, 10, 10, it makes it a lot easier. Let me show you what to do. So let's begin the first section of two sections that we need to do. We need to chain up one first, and right in the very first one right here, you're going to put in one single crochet. So that's what it says as per the pattern, and then it says to do the other 9, but I want you to count in 10, so that's considered 1 of 10. So let's do and count 10 out. So this is number 2, these are single crochets for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So there's your first 10 single crochets. So you see it, see how it's kind of extending it out already? The next 10 are half double crochets. So you're gonna do 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So there is your 10 half double crochets. So we've done 10, 10. Now we're gonna do 43 double crochets in a row. You unfortunately have to count that. So I'm gonna count, and if you wanna speed me up, you can, and if you just wanna go with me, you can. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. This is 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, and 43. So there's your 43. This is where you are compared to the end. So the next 10 are gonna be 10 half double crochets. So let's continue. Let's get this done. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now the remaining is gonna be 10 single crochets in a row. So let's do those. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Once you get your 10, just slip stitch to the very next one, just slip it, and you're ready. And that concludes that section there. We're gonna turn our work, so just turn it upside down, and we're gonna go back in the other direction, and we're gonna complete and go in the other direction. Let me show you some tips. So now that we've already turned our work, we're going to simply just start in the next one. So we've slipped into this one, so we're gonna go right to the next one. We're not gonna chain one first, and we're just going to do 10 single crochets, 10 half double crochets, 43 double crochets, 10 half double crochets, and 10 singles. So you can kind of look and see where it builds and where it changes. So here is half doubles. I see it changes right here. You have to match. So if you can identify these stitches, you don't even have to count anything because you can see it. Do you see that? And so if you get to the other side, you'll see that it's gonna drop off as soon as the double crochet stops. So here's the last double crochet. I can see that. Okay, half doubles, and then I can see that it changes the singles. If you can identify that, you don't have to count. And if you are wanting to make sure you count, then count. It's up to you. So remember, it's 10 singles, 10 halves, 43 doubles, 10 halves, and 10 singles to get you to the other side. So please do that now, and I'll see you there in just a moment. So once you get to the last stitch like so, you are going to now fasten off and then use your darning needle like I showed with the wiener in order to finish this off. So you have to do a total of 4 of these buns. So this is 1 of 4. So you have to do 3 more of these, and then we're going to start the main assembly next because I've already done my homework off camera and I'm ready to go. So I'll see you back here, and it's just like the wiener. Make sure that you glide your hook in place for up to three times. So once across, so 1, and then coming back in the other direction for 2. And the other direction for 3. Just like that. So I want you now and to get this done, and it's ready for final assembly time, and then we can do the adding of the toppings as well. That's just chain work, very very easy as well. So it's completely up to you and how you want to do that, and I'll see you back here for the assembly next. Of course, no hot dog is complete without decorating it, and we have some ketchup and mustard that are options, and there's just simple chain work in order to make it work. In this portion, I will show you what the designer suggests to do, and I'll add my own creativity to make the toppings look more realistic with dripping ketchup and mustard. So let's decorate our hot dogs. It's now time for decorating your hot dog. So there's ketchup and mustard, both are the same. All it is really is just a chaining of 140 in order to make it work. So just create a slip knot and go, and just chain 140, and then once you get your chain done, that's it. That's all you gotta do, and you can sew on your mustard afterwards. So for the ketchup and mustard, all it wants you to do is to chain 140 and then sew this chain down. Let me give you some ideas here. This is where I think you're gonna have a lot of fun. This is almost like a free forming, so there's no pattern from what I'm about to show you. I'm just gonna show you. So what I did, instead of chaining 140, I chained enough so that it can go in a straight line across the wiener from the bottom to the top, and it just stops just before you get to both sides of it. So like it doesn't go over top of the wiener like on the other side. So what I'm gonna do is that when I put on mustard on things, I'm never usually very neat about it. You won't ever find a perfect, you know, squirt like this. I get globs. And so for myself, I wanna be a little bit realistic with my own eating habits. And what I want to do is that second chain from the hook, I'm going to single crochet myself down this chain, and watch what happens when you do this. But I'm gonna show you even more techniques in just a moment. But look what happens when you single crochet. Now you bought the yarn anyway, so you might as well use more yarn because you have it in your hands. And look what you can do. You can take that little squirt of yarn that it suggested and thicken up the squirt so it's even more. But because I'm a sloppy kind of hot dog eater, we won't get into that too much here in today's tutorial, but I glob it. And so I'm gonna show you some freeform techniques that I'm gonna do with my wiener that you could do with yours. And let me just single crochet myself all the way down the chain, and then I'll show you what I'm gonna do next. So I'm all the way down. So now that I just converted the little squirt into a bigger squirt, and again you can do that with the 140 if you wanted to, and just kind of sew it into position, kind of doing all this kind of fun stuff and etc. But I'm gonna go even a little further. I'm gonna turn my work because you bought the yarn anyway, so might as well use it. So let's go. So what I like to do is that when I put on my toppings. I'm kind of messy about it. So I'm gonna chain up one and I'm gonna go across and I'm just gonna randomly do this. So I'm just gonna single crochet again, just randomly across, and then all of a sudden, oh, I just have a little glob. So I'm gonna skip two, and again, this is all suggestion. So I'm gonna do 7 double crochets into the next. This is going to create what appears to be a blob of extra that I accidentally squirted on. Now you're thinking to yourself, okay, that's kind of crazy. So there's 4. So I'm doing a total of 7. So that's 5, 6, and 7. And then I'm gonna skip 2 again. So skip 1, 2, go to the third, and single crochet in again. So now what I've just done is that I've created like a blob kind of idea. So when I go to put it on here, I'm gonna have a blob that kind of is leaking over here. So I'm gonna go all the way down, just randomly putting in blobs as I go. You can do single crochets, you can do half double crochets. So if this blob wasn't as big, so I'm gonna go to the second over and I'm gonna put in half double crochets, and I'm only gonna put 6. Again, there's no rhyme or reason, just do it, right? It's like free forming. I love free forming. It's one of my favorite things of crochet. And if life was ever perfect, then you know it'd be boring. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, as I said, skip 1 and then single crochet in the next. So this blob is not as big as the last blob. Do you see that? So then I'm gonna single crochet in some more, and next time I'm going to put in some trebles. That's right, so I'm gonna live dangerously. So I'm going to skip over, so 1, 2, 3, I'm gonna go to the fourth, and so trebles you wrap twice, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm going to put in 7. 7 seems to be a magic number, but in this case I could put 9. If you don't put enough, then it doesn't get the radius to go properly around. So what I'm just doing here is I'm improvising on the hot dog, giving it more of a realistic look on how you may decorate it yourself. And again, we all have our own habits. Some people really like a neat hot dog, and me, I just smother it on and throw it down my throat. So this is kind of like an idea. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me finish this one and then I'll leave the rest of it for you to improvise. And when I get to the other side, all I'm just gonna do is just kind of work my way down the other side of this chain and kind of blob it on the other side, but not equally, not in the equal spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, one more, 9. So that was even a bigger blob, just like so. So I'm gonna skip to the fourth. So just 1, 2, 3, and 4, and just start single crocheting back again. So this blob is even bigger than the other two blobs. See that? So when you go to lay it down like this and then you blob the other side, you're going to have like a layer of mustard that is all blobbed out all over the place. And again, the secret is to randomize it, and if you do so, you can have a really cool idea. So try that, see if it works for you, and then when we come back, we're gonna start the main assembly of this project. So here's what my glob looks like. Again, free form crochet, so I just put some stuff in here. I went down the opposite side, so I kind of did things so it looks like I was kind of drooling it as I went. You know, of course, nothing in life is ever perfect. So what you wanna do with these particular toppings is that you want to put your bun and your wieners together. So just do one panel, and then what you can just do then is just sew this down in top. So in this case, I could actually really kind of make it all kind of squirty and really kind of fun and do it like it shows in the photo. Even with my particular version, I might actually do that. Get that sewn, and then what you want to do is then match the other side. So I'm gonna talk about the assembly process because that's kind of the fun part of the whole thing. Finally, you're ready to position your wieners and buns together. Now look at the photograph and match what you see. Notice the wiener extends out further on the top than it does on the bottom, leaving the bottom edge more flat. Attach those buns and wieners together first, then apply your toppings. You will then have 2 different panels, and you will use a whip stitch around the outside, leaving a hole at the top of the hot dog for the child to slip into the snuggle sack. So now it's time to do the final assembly. Let me talk about some of the elements to do in this, and actually the final assembly is not as hard as it looks, and it's actually quite easy. So let's begin. So if you remember, we are actually doing 2 sets of panels. So we're doing one panel on one, and then we're doing a second. So in actual fact, you have 2 wieners, and 4 buns, just like so. And so what our goal is then to put them together. Now behind me, I've already put things together in here, and I'm going to show you how I assembled it as far as like putting it as a whip stitch together. So you'll see that there's a little bit of a gap here, but you see that I fastened on the hot dog bun to the wiener. So for the sewing element, we're gonna come up and you're going to concentrate on the bun. So use the same bun color in order to sew it. So you can actually, you can't see it here, but this is an actual one. I can just happen to see it there because I'm trained professional, so don't question me on these things. So I sewed it here, and so if you flip it over, you can see where I've done all the attaching, and then of course you can see it on the other side. So this is the inside of where the child will be on the inside. So you can see that there's a bit of an overlap right here. So I made sure that when I went through the wiener completely. I didn't just go through a top layer so that it's nice and secure, but here it's nice and tight. So even on the other side, nice and tight. You wanna make sure that when you're jumping over, you can jump over like 2 or 3 stitches, but don't jump in any more than that, because then you'll end up with children that can put their fingers through holes. So you wanna be able to come down like this. So it's just a matter of just working your way in and out of the stitches. So when you cut the strands to do this, cut it long enough that you can use one strand to go the entire length of your bun in order to do so. Therefore, you won't have any cut pieces of yarn in between, and go right up to the top. Let's look at what's going on at the top. So as I come up to the top, what I wanted to do is that I put down the one wiener first, and then I just did a hatching, not actually sewing, so that I could match it, and then I went directly across and started the other one, so they're both at the same thing. So on the very top, the wiener hangs out more than the buns, and that's completely intentional. So what you want to do when you go down your wiener, you want to make sure that the buns are kind of matching. See how this line kind of matches? Do you see that? And it happens on the other side too. So use the lines that are in your crochet in order to match it up when you're going to do all the sewing. So now I'm gonna speed you up, and I'm gonna show you how to do this, and this is actually a lot of fun, and good luck, and we'll see you again real soon. So that's it for today, my friends at yarnspirations.com and myself, Mikey of the Crochet Crowd. We would love to thank you so much sincerely for joining us with our Hot Dogging Snuggle Sack today. It's been a pleasure to teach you, and of course if you're looking for more free patterns and tutorial ideas, you can count on us to keep the inspiration free and the ideas flowing. Have an amazing day. Hope to see you back here again real soon. See ya. Bye-bye.